This will be interesting to see how long Ann chooses to stand with Mazepa, who's a world wushu champion. Just like that, she takes it to the ground.
Well, they were both swinging nicely with punches. Mazepa particularly impressive, and Ann went for the takedown. Ooh. And she's right on top of her and in control here, to the roar of the crowd at Stadium Putra.
We know how much work Mazepa has put in on her stand-up game, but what can she do on the ground against an animal like Ann Osman?
This is her MMA debut, but she was preparing for a fight with Ana Hulatin in the middle of last year in Dubai. Now, she got injured and had to come out. Ann Osman stepped into that fight as her replacement and beat Hulatin, and that catapulted her to the position she's in now.
Ann Osman's just smothering Mazepa at this point. Let's see what kind of ground game the Wushu world champion has. She's just kind of holding on here, not really initiating anything, not really showing. She's holding on to the half guard.
Mazepa's pulling her in very close there. She doesn't want to give Ann Osman any space to do any damaging work, but the ground and pound, which Ann Osman is famous, working its magic there on the forehead and around the right eye. That will do some damage. If she gets a little more space, you'll see Osman use the forearm and the elbow as well.
Osman slid that leg out of Mazepa's half guard, and now she's in full mount. But oh, she reverses it!
Great reversal, like a bucking bronco.
Mazepa reverses the mount position and has now put Osman on the back. Let's see what Ann can do here from this position.
And it's Mazepa who's throwing down the forearms that I highlighted for you, Osman might.
Oh, and nice sweep! That's off.
Beautifully done. Can she pull it off? Not quite. They both stand up. Osman takes a knee to the head in the process.
And Osman pushes Mazepa up against the cage here.
Mazepa is the stronger, taller woman, but that lower center of gravity may give Osman an advantage here as she presses her opponent up against the cage wall. Ann takes a knee to the stomach and a second one to the hip. A third slightly lower down. Remember, Mazepa is a kickboxer. She's used to those knees and kicks. You cannot grab the cage. I wonder how the judges will see there, because Osman was in the process of a takedown and gripping the cage may have prevented that.
Now she's controlling the right hand there on Mazepa,
taking matters into her own hands so that she can't grip the cage.
And Osman is just tenacious in this takedown attempt, pushing Mazepa up
against
the cage.
Oh, takes a good punch. Oh,
she drops her!
And it's finished. It's finished.
Mazepa drops her with a big left hand.
It was a huge swinging left hook.
Osman is out. What a finish.
A huge swinging left hook from Irina Mazepa. Ann Osman fell to the canvas immediately, and there was really no need for the follow-up because she was out. And Mazepa has taken herself to the very top of the tree in ONE Championship's female mixed martial arts arena. Here it is again. There's the left hook. Down she went, and that was it. Nothing more was needed.
She just creates a little bit of space.
Oh, the fury, Mitch, the fury of those three punches.
Look at this, she pushes away, she sets up one, two, and then the hook, and down goes Osman right on the chin. That is the power of Irina Mazepa.
Huge disappointment for everyone here in Stadium Putra. Much as we love to see new talent come into the cage and perform valiantly,
the crowd is absolutely shocked.
People love Ann Osman here, and nobody wanted to see her lose, let alone lose this way. She's got to her feet, she's a bit unsteady, but she's standing of her own accord. A little bit dazed, no doubt.
To present the prize to the winner, we have Jason Lowe, CEO of Toon Talk. Ladies and gentlemen, referee Joey Lepitin calls a halt to this battle at 3:05 of round number one. For your winner, via referee stoppage due to strikes, Irina Mazepa!
atomweight contest. Rashi Shinde of Mumbai, India, 28 years old, but Stamp Fairtex from Pattaya, Thailand, 26, on the left of your screen. You've seen this woman in Muay Thai contest before, Mitch, and fair to say you've been impressed, and that's probably why. My goodness me, my buddy Mitch Chilston didn't even get a word in edgeways. What a finish. Talk, Mitch.
Beautifully done. Did you see that? She went low with the leg kick. Rashi was thinking about the leg kick because that leg kick must have hurt, and then boom, ended the night for Rashi with a beautiful head kick.
Here we go. You're going to get three looks at it. There's the first.
Bingo.
I'm not surprised there was no getting up from that.
Look at this. Sweet chin music.
Oh, wow.
Just goes right up top. Beautifully done for Stamp Fairtex. There's
the way
a
she
reason.
She moves her hips and gets her body weight behind that, and that landed flush.
That's how you make an impact at one Warrior Series.
Oh.
We don't.
This one should be interesting. Hope you're enjoying all the action live on Facebook, live on Twitter. If you're not following us, make sure you do. At One Championship. Inside leg kicks early. Orsinio said she worked the kicks in training for this one. Said that Torres's kick defense is not apparent. Looking for a choke early here is April Orsinio.
There's a guillotine nice and tight, but it looks like she's going to pop her head out as she does. I like how Arsenio was setting up those low kicks. She threw three inside low kicks and then followed up, faked the third one, and threw a big right hand. Armbar.
Armbar coming from April Orsinio. Oh, and
Torres. Oh! Oh, it's good night, Irene! That's why she is awesome! Joe Marie Torres, 3-0. The revelation continues her winning reign. My word! She is awesome!
Joe Marie. I froze for about 30 seconds there, Michael. Had the arm bar. April Orsinio locked it up.
I'll tell you what, Mitch, that is a contender for the GoDaddy knockout of the night.
Man, I don't know. GoDaddy's gotta give it to Joe Mary. Look at this. April throws up the arm bar, one of her favorite submissions. Joe Mary Torres clasps the hands, sends her up, and takes her for the ride.
Can you believe it? Not even a year ago, even 8 months ago, nobody knew the name Joe Marie Torres. And look what she's doing to opponents now. First Rika Ishiga. Now, April Orsinio made it look easy. My word, the sky's the limit for Joe Marie Torres. She is something special. 3-0 with Renee Catalan in her corner. Just amazing young woman. Incredible. That atomweight, what a force. Absolute force, Joe Marie Torres. A beast in the cage and the shyest woman you're ever gonna meet outside the cage. Let's go to Dominic Lau to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kemp Chang, has put a stop to this contest after 40 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of knockout, Joe Marie Torres!
On the One Fantasy game, on the One Super app, the world's largest martial arts fantasy game, an overwhelming 71% of fans favoring a win for Ming Bo over Laura Ballard. We're on the ground early, which is where Ballon prefers to be, though Ming Bo does have a background in wrestling. So top position is where Ming Bo wants to be on the ground. Poses the guard as Ballon.
Watch out back of the
head. Argentinian likes to choke out opponents. 5 wins by choke, 4 by rear naked choke. Doesn't fare well on the road. A 5th time competing outside of Argentina. 1-3 on the road to date for Laura Ballon. Has finished by sub in 3 of her last 4 losses. Got to be careful because Ming Bo possesses a lot of weapons and does have 5 submissions in 13 wins. If it gets to the feet, Ming Bo 3-0 in Muay Thai, 3 knockouts in 13 wins in mixed martial arts. Ming Bo, a very highly anticipated one debut She'd been scheduled to make her debut here twice before, but both times it was delayed, resulting in that long layoff I spoke about earlier. But she says there'll be no ring rust tonight. I'm fully prepared. She's been waiting a long time as Laura Ballin has a very high guard on Mingbo.
Ballin's trying to attack an arm, I think, on the right side. She's got a nice high guard. Now she's got that leg up above the right shoulder of Mingbo. She was almost gated.
This crowd in Beijing allowed for Mingbo. She will bring down the roof on the Cadillac Arena if she wins, especially if she wins by knockout or submission. Slings the legs a little. Confidence oozing out of every pore of Mingbo. Slings the legs some more. Will she allow Ballin back to her feet?
Stop.
And indeed, referee does her that favor. Bo comes forward. Jack. Ballin. Produces a huge win for China here in Beijing.
Wow, what a right hand. An absolute hammer. Our current strawweight queen, Xiong Jingna, couldn't even finish Laura Ballin. It took her five rounds. Went to a decision. Mingbo gets it done in the very first. Look at this right hand. Waves, boom, right on the chin.
I tell you what, folks, Age of Dragons in Beijing is producing a night of the most electrifying and fastest finishers in one championship history. What is that, Mitch? Three matches, three finishers, all in the first round. It has been amazing. Let's go to Tom Lau and make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Cost, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 18 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of knockout, Mingbo!
Angela Lee, Xiong Jingna Lee, the atomweight world champion. Xiong Jingna, the strawweight world champion. Both come out slinging the hands. Xiong Jingna may have the edge in power in the hands. Angela will have the edge on the ground. Overhand there from Xiong Jingna, trying to back up. Angela Lee goes to the body. You feel Xiong Jingna isn't quite settled here yet. Inside the opening 30 seconds, looks a little more jittery than Angela Lee.
Angela's very composed. She's been there. She's been in these moments a long time, so she knows what to do, even at such a young age. The Lee clan has told me that Xiong Jingna gets disrupted when she gets hit. She starts to flurry. She starts to get wild when she gets touched up, and that's what Angela's planning on doing. She wants to touch up the face of Xiong Jingna and get her to overcommit and then lead to the takedown. Right now, she's inside the clinch. Let's see what Xiong Jingna can do.
Angela Lee, atomweight world champion, 9-0, undefeated. Xiong Jingna goes to ground for the very first time. Top position for Angela Lee.
Very committed takedown by Angela Lee. Let's see what she can do now in side control.
And a pin that right arm of the champion and bangs away to the face between the eyes of Xiong Jingna.
This is a bad spot for Xiong Jingna. She's got to be composed. She's got to stay relaxed. She's got to try to work her way back into half guard, which she does. Now she's got to try to get an underhook on that side of where Angela Lee is. Angela Lee right now has an underhook on the right side of Xiong Jingna. So she has to try to get that underhook. She has to try to swim her right arm underneath the arm of Angela Lee and start to work her way up the cage. Angela Lee has tremendous top pressure.
Angela Lee right in front of her corner, her father and head coach Ken Lee, also her brother Christian Lee in the corner. You see them both there on the right of your screen. Her husband Bruno Pucci watching back in Hawaii on BR Live and TNT. Big hello to Bruno Pucci.
Breathe, Bruno.
On her back here, the champion, Xiong Jingna of China, who trains out of Bali MMA in Indonesia these days with Big Mike Clay, Don Carlo Klaus, and all the team there. Good job. One of the main sparring partners for this one was Tiffany Van Soest, who's also here in Tokyo.
Good job by Xiong Jingnan to get her feet on the hips of Angela Lee and create a little bit of space. Angela Lee's jumping on the neck now. Possible front headlock. Let's see, Xiong Jingnan's got to separate those hands. Works her way back up to the feet. In a bad spot for some knees. Angelique's looking for possibly a Darce choke. She's got an opportunity here to slide her left arm onto her own bicep and clasp on a choke. Might just choose to soften her up with the knees right now.
It's set for 5 rounds for the women's strawweight world title, but most pundits say it won't go that far. Gut-munching knee there from Xiong Jingnan, the champion, and she breaks away from the left hook.
Nice little confidence boost from Xiong Jingnan to get back up to her feet. You can see the way she celebrated by clapping her hands. Now she's trying to shake out her hands.
I wonder if Jean is trying to play a counter game here with Angela. Wants Angela to strike first. Seems to be that way. Gets it with a nice left hand there to Xiong Jingnan. Another left hand for the champion. And circles off counterclockwise. Drops the lead hand down to the bread basket. Now drifts off in the opposite direction. Angela ties her up again. Takes a knee to the upper left ribs.
Xiong Jingnan's got to be careful in these clinch positions. She's allowing Angela Lee to close too much distance. She has to circle around. She has to create movement. She has to create that chaos. Headlock takedown now. Xiong Jingnan might be able to pop her head out. Good job. Get back into the separation.
Xiong Jingnan threw a knee, broke off there. Let's see if she can get the power salvos off her hands now. Xiong Jingnan, the punching panda. Saw her come out on an absolute blaze when she entered one championship, tearing up Abriel Senio and then demolishing Tiffany Teo on her way to win that world title. Big right hand for the punching panda. Here she comes.
Nice right hands.
Angela Lee got her first real taste of Xiong Jingnan's power in that right hand, bitch.
Yeah, Xiong Jingnan answered those right hands with shots of her own.
Circling again. Counterclockwise is the champion. Good left hook, then rips down on the liver, overhand right to the knuckles over.
Angela Lee's doing a good job, though, of cutting the angles of Xiong Jingnan. You can see that pressure. She's trying to move in, get into that clinch, and work for that takedown. Xiong Jingnan's trying to circle out, but Angela Lee's doing a good job of cutting her off. Looks like we might see a second round here, Michael Shelley.
Angela did predict she would finish Xiong Jingnan in the first. I don't think we're going to see that. Both women landing right hands. It was maybe Angela who drew the short straw. Thought about a front kick, did leave. And we go to the towels at the end of one. World champion Yosuke Tsuruta also in the house. He'll be on our next card. Main event in Manila, April 12 at the Mall of Asia Arena. Defending that belt against Joshua Pascio.
On the ground, this is where Angela is most dangerous. Look at her. She's got that front headlock position. She lands a nice knee to the left side of the face of Xiong Jingnan. There's Xiong Jingnan throwing that overhand right, catches the shoulder of Angela Lee. Angela Lee's doing a good job of defending. Xiong Jingnan needs to mix things up a little bit. Constant movement, not allow Angela Lee to back her up into the cage. I like Angela Lee working into that clinch and dragging her down. She's got that nice little headlock takedown that she's using very effectively to put Xiong Jingnan on her back and soften her up. Good round for Angela Lee.
Hey,
we are ready to rock and roll. Second round set for 5 for the world strawweight title. The atomweight world champion Angela Lee, the strawweight world champion Xiong Jingnan, the sold-out Rio Goku Koku Kika. Great choice for the first ever event of one championship in Japan. No greater building of martial arts history than here at the Rio Goku Koku Gikan. Its hallowed hallways have been built by so many great martial arts champions over the years. Corking knee there from Xiong Jingnan. Angela turns her around nicely, bats the champ against the cage.
She's very tight in that clinch position. She's got her hands locked. She might try to step over inside, take her right leg across the body, and throw Xiong Jingnan down again. Jingnan's got to try to swim in. She's got to create a little bit of space on that right side. She has to try to get her arm on underneath the arm of Angela Lee and break away.
Knee there from Xiong Jingnan.
I see somebody turn the corner here, a little bit of redirection here.
Is Xiong Jingnan playing the right game at the moment, Mitch?
Well, I don't know if it's the right game, but she's doing okay, and she's been able to get out of a few bad positions that Angela Lee's had her in. Now, Angela Lee is a black belt. She's submitted a lot of people And Zhong Jingnan's done a good job of keeping her composure and working her way back up to her feet. I'd like to see Zhong Jingnan start throwing hands and then maybe some kicks, soften up the legs, throw those leg kicks to Angela Lee and then circle out. She's allowing Angela Lee to back her up against the cage inside these clinch positions, but she's able to escape and create space. So that's gonna build her confidence.
The space allows the strike, which is the power side of Zhong Jingnan. Will she strike first? Does she want to play the counter game here with Angela Lee? Looking through her brow, threads the right hand. Lee, nicely done to cut off the movement of the champion. Looks for the right hand as Lee, couldn't find it, resets herself. How do you see Lee carrying herself so far with this extra weight, Mitch, going up a weight division here to strawweight?
I think she looks great at strawweight. She was happy, she was composed all week, and she's gonna be stronger, but you gotta wonder, how did that back injury play into things? The back is involved in so many aspects of mixed martial arts, especially when you have a grappler with strength of Angela Lee. How is that gonna affect her game? And that could be part of the reason, I don't wanna speculate, but part of the reason why Zhong Jingnan's been able to escape a lot of these close encounters.
They were scheduled to compete against each other in November last year in Singapore. A bulging disc in the back of Angela Lee prevented that. And here we are in Tokyo tonight in the biggest card in history. One championship, a new era. Angela Lee backed against the cage, knees to the thigh there from Zhong Jingnan. Lee turns her around.
Good job, that. Now she's working the underhook. See how she swam that arm in? Now she's got control. I'd like her to jack that arm up. Otherwise, she might go for a ride here. Angela Lee's been able to drag her to the ground twice now. Good adjustment on the body position there from Zhong Jingnan. Let's see if Angela Lee can get her down. Oh, a takedown attempt there from Zhong Jingnan. She exits with a punch.
Zhong Jingnan, an opportunity to work the hands. There's a nicely threaded overhand lead there. Circles off to her right, away from the power side of Angela.
Zhong Jingnan looks a little bit stiffer than we've seen her in the past. You can see her shoulders are kind of shrugged up next to her ears. I don't know if that's a defensive tactic as far as rolling with the punches and, you know, using the shoulder to block it, but she looks a little bit stiffer than we've seen her in the past.
Mitch, any chance that part of the plan of Zhong Jingnan may be to draw Angela into really deep water and test Angela at strawweight?
I mean, it makes sense. You know, it could be that Angela may start to fade in the later rounds. That's what they're hoping for. They're hoping to draw this out to see a third, fourth, and fifth round because they're hoping that Angela Lee, after her back injury, after her car accident, hasn't been able to put the time in on the mat. And that could be when Zhong Jingnan chooses to step it up a level and really start pushing the pace, because she seems very composed and relaxed. She's not breathing heavy, neither of them are. And Angela Lee doesn't look to be fading at all.
Still great to see the hashtag One Championship trending tops in the USA right now on Twitter. Has been for the last hour and a half or so. Great to see. Big hello to all of our American viewers watching on TNT. Outside leg kick there from Angela. Roundhouse kick from Zhong Jingnan. Under 30 seconds remain, second round of five. Could it be the master plan of Zhong Jingnan to draw Angela Lee to deep water? Test Lee's cardio, test that extra weight. Step upside kick there. Zhong Jingnan tries to back her up with the right hand. There's a left hook from the champion and an inside thigh kick. She talks to Angela. She pulls her forward. Angela's not going to be sucking into a brawl. She's too clever for that. We're going into another round.
Look at this, inside the clinch, Angela's doing good work. Look at that, over the top elbow. And the arm come down on Zhong Jingnan. She was able to land a nice overhand elbow there. And then Zhong Jingnan was finally able to have some success inside the clinch. Look at that beautiful little trip there from Zhong Jingnan. She answers or exits with a punch. Good job from both these ladies in that round. We're starting to see them. You know, this is when that cardio is gonna start to come into play. You know Zhong Jingnan can go hard for five rounds. Angela Lee has gone hard five rounds in the past, but how is it right now?
If you want to win an all expenses paid VVIP experience at One Championship, find out how now. Go to onefc.com/win. onefc.com/win and find out how you can win a very, very important person's experience.
Ready?
Third round number five for the strawweight world title, Angela Lee in the black, looking to become the first ever two-division women's champion at one championship. Xiong Jinan looking to retain. A little more gusto behind both these martial arts champions here to start the third. Angela presses the champ against the cage.
Right now, Xiong Jinan's trying to get that underhook on that one side. You can see she's trying to go for a body lock. Angela's got her pressed up against the cage. She's got that driving that shoulder into the chin, into the chest there of Xiong Jinan. That's able to keep her pressed up against the cage like that. Xiong Jinan's now got the underhook. Might be able to circle out, and she does. Angela goes for the body lock, changes levels. Let's see if she can get the takedown again. She's utilizing, she's changing up her game as far as the takedowns are concerned. Look at that beautiful hip toss there. She grabbed the body lock. She was able to turn the corner and put Xiong Jinan on her back. This is where Angela Lee is most dangerous.
Open guard here from Xiong Jinan on her back. Let's see what Angela can do. So many submission variations that Angela is capable of. She can tie you up like a pretzel, like a ball of twine, and tap you out from anywhere. But what's Xiong Jinan been working on? She throws the legs up a little higher, Dragon.
She went for the rubber guard there. Let's see what she can do. She's trying to control the arms here of Angela Lee. She's got that guard nice and high, but yet trying to attack an arm. Punching up the face there of Angela Lee. Angela Lee takes that leg for a ride, puts her on her back.
Up and down, start control for Angela Lee. Cuts the hip in, does the atomweight champion of the world. North-south position now.
Looking for a Kimura. Might possibly go for an armbar here.
Is Angela going to take that arm home with her? Xiong Jinan back to her feet and momentarily out of trouble. A back-and-forth contest, a seesawing battle for the strawweight crowd. Hear the pin drop silence in the Rio Gokukoku Giga, the most educated martial arts fans in the world here in Japan. I've been coming here for 18 years now, and they're always the same, Mitch. There are no smarter, no more appreciative fans in the martial arts world than the Japanese.
And there's a lot of technique for them to appreciate in this match here. Xiong Jinan's got to keep that space. She has to keep that separation, keep it in the middle of the cage, allow her to do work with those hands. Angela Lee's controlling a lot of the exchanges inside the clinch.
Xiong Jinan shakes out the hands, resets as the champion, fires out a front kick, nicely placed to the midsection. Angela edging forward. Xiong Jinan beats her with a punch, two-punch combination. Overhand right from Xiong Jinan. Past the halfway point of this entire match. Left hook, right hand, the old 3-2 there from Xiong Jinan. Mitch, who would you have ahead at the moment?
Nice spinning back kick there from Xiong Jinan. At this point, I would have to say Angela Lee's ahead just because she's controlling a lot of the exchanges on the ground and up against the clinch. But Xiong Jinan is starting to turn it up right now. She's landed about 12 to 13 different shots here. Landed that spinning back kick.
Oh, left hook there from Xiong Jinan. And Angela does a quick count of her teeth.
Angela's eating a few punches, but she's still remaining composed. Standing there in front. Not really shooting for takedowns either.
Loading up on these rods and left hooks is Xiong Jinan. More hooks than a tackle box on the champion. And again, smack bang between the eyes. Overhand right from Xiong Jinan. Goes for the headache maker. Looks for a side kick. Angela backed off again with the right hand from Xiong Jinan. This is a great portion of the contest for the champion.
This has been the most successful portion of the time for Xiong Jinan. Angela Lee was starting to get touched up there in that middle part of that round. You could see she was taking a lot of shots, but she's remaining composed and she's still pushing forward. I see Angela Lee change up the game here, start throwing leg kicks. Go for a takedown. She hasn't taken one shot yet. Her only takedown attempts have been in the clinch up against the cage.
Xiong Jinan, chin tucked, looking through her brow. The champion's been on the money so far in this round with her striking. Here she comes again. The chin locks back on Angela Lee. There's an overhand right. There's a body shot. Lee's going to get off the cage here. And they clinch up. She locks down the arm to the champion. And here come the knees from Xiong Jinan. What a round from the Chinese world champion, Xiong Jinan. Angela threads a couple of knees to the right ribs. We do score on an overall contest, not round by round, but this has been a phenomenal round for Zhong Jinan, a round in which the champion found her range. And look who we've got in the crowd tonight, Mitch.
Rafael Dos Anjos is here in Japan enjoying the Women's Strawweight World Championship. I know he's part of Evolve Mixed Martial Arts, and he's enjoying the work that Angela Lee has put in, at least in the first half of this contest. We have to wonder, is the second half of this contest gonna go the way of the Chinese Punching Panda? You can see her starting to overwhelm Angela Lee, landing big shots, flurrying on her. Angela Lee's getting caught up in the commotion, the chaos created by the champ.
What I like there, we saw it on the replay, Mitch. Angela took two, I think it may have been three solid right hands. She had the composure, though, to do a little pirouette, a little quarter turn, and then strike back with two punches of her own.
She's a high-level martial artist.
A lot of questions people had about what sort of punch Angela Lee could take from a heavier opponent, from the punching of Zhong Jinan. It adds a lot of questions right there.
Well, we saw the punch coming from Mei Yamaguchi, the big right hand that dropped Angela Lee. Angela Lee was still able to come back. Ooh, she just caught a left hook there by Zhong Jinan.
Oh, and a right hand from Angela, tagged her on the chin. That was nicely done.
Like the change up here, game plan. Angela Lee going after the trip, getting Zhong Jinan to the ground.
You see the change of tact here from Angela Lee. They talked to her in the corner. They said, take it down. Let's not let her strike against you. Let's get it to ground. That's your territory. That's Leeville. That's Leeville.
Right as Zhong Jinan was starting to see a little bit of momentum, Angela Lee was able to put a stop to it and move on. Look, now she's inside. Now she's in half guard. Let's see what she can do here. Zhong Jinan's got to keep her nice and tight. She's got possibly the overhook on the opposite side. You can see that far arm is over the head of Angela Lee. She's got to try to get it under. I think now she's just trying to stall and wait possibly for a stand-up. Angela Lee's not going to allow the position to go inactive for very long. She's going to start doing work.
Angela Lee came in many people's eyes as the favorite for this one. Zhong Jinan, it looks like the game plan all along is to draw Angela into deep water. Close guard now from the strawweight champion, Zhong Jinan. Angela trying to posture up, trying to break it open, work some ground and pound back. Hammer fist strike there from the atomweight world champion.
Good job from Zhong Jinan to get back into guard, feet on the hips.
Up kick there from Zhong Jinan. And another one. Angela, side control, nicely done. Let's see where she goes from here, Mitch.
You can see Zhong Jinan's trying to keep that head nice and close to her body to control the posture. She's trying to walk up the cage now, create a scramble here. She's got to keep moving. She can't allow Angela Lee to start setting up these submissions.
Angela did not expect to be here. She thought she would have Zhong Jinan out in the first round. And here we are in the penultimate, the fourth of five. 3 minutes remaining. And now in what they do call the deep water. Side control still for Angela Lee. What are the options here for Lee? What can Zhong Jinan do, Mitch?
Right now she's got that head in control with her left arm. And she's going neon belly. She might try to slide over into mount. Oh, Zhong Jinan gives up her back. Zhong Jinan might be able to escape out the back door, but she's got to be careful she doesn't give up her arm. Angela Lee's got a tight squeeze here. Might be an inverse triangle.
It looks like a demented game of Twister here between Zhong Jinan and Angela Lee. Angela always hunting for a way to finish when it's on the ground, when it's on the feet. And you know the Punching Panda wants to get back to striking range.
Look at the way Angela Lee has that leg locked up. She's got that nice and tight. She's hunting after the arm right now. She does have the triangle possibly in. You can see how the triangle is locked up with her left leg underneath the knee of her right leg, and that's nice and tight. So she's gonna try to extend the arm here. She's gonna try to create a little bit of space and get.
Oh, is she gonna do it? Is she gonna tap out Zhong Jinan? Not yet. Referee Kim Cheng right on top of it. Angela's gonna try and soften up the champion a little more. Still 1 minute 35 remains in this fourth round. Angela wants the armbar. She wants to take the arm home. Could the title be slipping away from Zhong Jinan? Is Unstoppable gonna make history? Is she?
Oh, can she? It's not supposed to bend that
way. Can she make history, Angela Lee? She's going for it.
Look how tight that is. Look how tight the triangle is. She can't go anywhere. Watch the thumb.
She's going for it. Will she become a two-division champion?
She's still got a minute to work here. Zhong Jingnan's got to move. She's got to scramble.
Angela wants to take the arm home. Zhong Jingnan surviving. But with what punishment, with what damage? Angela softens her up a little more. Can she sense a victory soon? Can she smell a sub coming?
This is a long time for Zhong Jingnan to be trapped in this triangle. She's got to move. She can't go anywhere, though. She's just taking the beating.
Oh, here he goes again. That looks bad. That looks dangerous.
Zhong Jingnan won't give up.
This is crazy. Zhong Jingnan will not tap out. A belly down armbar from Angela Lee. And Zhong Jingnan, look at her face. Look at her grimacing. But she gives a thumbs up to referee Kemp Chang.
There's a bit of space there in the triangle. You can see she doesn't have quite have that choking because look at the legs. Her foot is down near the calf, so she can't quite get that nice and tight. The armbar is there, though. Zhong Jingnan, there's Will Quintner. She's okay.
Her face is turning purple. But the bell's almost here. A few more seconds. And the champion survives. The champion survives. We're going in to the fifth and final round.
That's hard. That's hard. Hard. Her family keeps her in the match. She won't quit. There's no quit. Fifth round. At this point, that's a near finish. Look at this. Parries the hand down. Gets the hands deflected away and comes right through the middle with a face rattling right hand. Beautiful. Then she slips underneath. The counter shot gets to the clinch, and that led to the triangle we just saw. That was a long time to be trapped inside that reverse triangle.
Folks, come and join us. Come and see a one championship event live. All expenses paid. It's on us. To find out how, go to onefc.com/win. onefc.com/win. We'll bring you to one championship. All expenses paid. We are seeing a gripping match for the strawweight world title. The survival of Zhong Jingnan, the champion, in front of a sellout crowd inside the Rio Gokugoku Gigan in Tokyo, Japan. The one championship, a new era. 5 minutes remains for either Zhong Jingnan to retain or for Angela Lee to become an historic two-division world champion. Early trade of leather here. Zhong Jingnan showing damage around the right eye.
Angela Lee took two shots, shook her head, said, you got nothing on me. Zhong Jingnan's gonna need a big round if she's gonna wanna take this. Well, she has to go for the finish. Nice body kick. Angela Lee grimaced just a bit on it.
Side kick there from Zhong Jingnan. Oh, big overhand right, the knees almost went. Angela Lee's knees almost went. There was the power of the champion. She goes to the body.
Looks exhausted at this point. There's not a lot coming back from the atomweight champ.
And this is what Zhong Jingnan wanted. This was the game plan all along. Draw her into deep water and punish her in the fifth round. Let's see what Zhong Jingnan to do now.
I think Angela Lee might have blew her gas tank out when she went for that triangle armbar finish. Her mouth is wide open. She's taking big shots.
This is Zhong Jingnan's time. This is when she's gonna go for it. She's gonna pull out all the stuff. Throw caution to the wind. Angela Lee is blowing heavy. We've never seen Angela like this before. And here comes Zhong Jingnan with the overhand right. Another side kick. Straight into the guts of the atomweight champion. And a high hand. Angela's hurt. The body shot hurt her. The punching panda. Angela's in trouble. Angela's in trouble. Genius! It's brilliant! It's Zhong Jingnan! The unstoppable has been stopped!
The body shots did it! She started kicking the body. You can see Angela Lee didn't have anything left in the fifth and final round. She put it all in to that triangle armbar finish. And when Zhong Jingnan was able to survive the fourth round, she came back and the glory, and still one strawweight world champion, Zhong Jingnan.
No Mitch, she did not tell us the game plan yesterday when we begged her to tell us, but it was evident by the time the third round rolled. She wanted to draw her into the fourth and fifth. She knew that Angela would gas out, and she punished her, and she retains the crown. What a performance from Xiong Xindan.
The body shots, you can see right there. Angela Lee winces, and Xiong Xindan jumps all over here, landing big shots. The kicks to the body were the ones that did it. Look at this, super slow-mo, straight right hand to the solar plexus, crumbles the atomweight champion, and then Xiong Xindan kept going after it. What a performance to stop Unstoppable and retain her belt.
Let's go to Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, presenting the belt for this match, please welcome Mr. Chatri Sityotong, founder, chairman, and CEO of One Championship. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kent Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 37 seconds in the fifth and final round for your winner by way of technical knockout, and still one women's strawweight world champion, Xiong Xindan.